And so, all of a sudden, by coming here, you go into a season of divine recovery. Everybody shout recovery. Listen, all you had to do was show up today to get this started. You didn't have to come here to do a lot, but once you respond to what God is saying to us, all of a sudden it's activated. That means recovery means you are going to recuperate or regain what's been lost or taken from you. This whole decade is about that. Hear me, First People. Get ready. There's things coming back that got taken away. I read it this morning in the news. You know, we can get all political, but I love because a Republican senator said something he shouldn't about the First People. They turned on him like a mad dog. Because we need to understand God has an order for recovery. And he is putting us in the order for recovery. You regain your health. We have been prone to agree with sickness, with infirmity. I love us having cautious faith and learning cautious faith over the last year and a half. But we cannot succumb to the fear of infirmity. If you do that, it will overtake you. Because fear is a spirit. Yeshua said, infirmity was a spirit. They will link up together in a double portion and bend you over. That's what infirmity means. It will weaken you so you can't stand. We are returning to a new state of authority. Alabama, you're leading the way into a state of authority that has more meanings than one. We're saving ourselves from when we slipped and fell last season. You can't worry about always, never. If you slip and fall, the righteous get up seven times. Now, don't be presumptive and press on the Lord so that you keep doing things that you shouldn't be doing. But if you slip and fall, he has ways to get you back up. And that's part of recovery. We regain, we reclaim land and substances. You need to have a list of reclamations where you are reclaiming things that you need to know come back in through your portion that were blocked from you in other seasons. Listen, if God hadn't given me revelation of this, I really don't. It's my whole life message, this is. Reclaiming what was taken in every area. And the Lord has made me do some interesting things to reclaim what was illegally, and the enemy got his hands on in the portion we were given in the earth realm. And the Lord knew I could be faithful to do it for our family. He wasn't waiting on my grandpa to get right. He wasn't waiting on my dad to get right. He wasn't waiting on anybody but me and that bloodline to come into alignment with him. So you quit pointing your finger at all the other people and say, here I am, Lord. Now, I really like this definition of recovery. You're coming out of a bad state of mind. I mean, you can get crazy out here in the world. It can just make you crazy. You can start believing what the atmosphere is saying to you. The Lord says you're becoming sound-minded. You are breaking a spirit of fear, and therefore you're thinking right. Now, I'm going to show you why this is so important in a minute. Then, once you start moving in recovery, restoration starts accelerating. Now, hear me. This is a word to Alabama. It is time for restoration to accelerate. And then restoration doesn't bring you back. Recovery brings you back to where you were at loss. Restoration brings you back, and there's a law of restoration that creates multiplication up to a thousandfold. Look at somebody and say, I'm going to get in this one way or the other. See, Pentecost represents this. That's what it's about. And so, all of a sudden, when we're here at the right time, at the right place, all the new God has for us is now. Shout it, the new is now. Arise, shine, your light has come. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. I will let people see the glory on you. I'll let him see the favor on you. I'll let you shine and radiate, Isaiah 60 says. I will cause the camels that used to come back to you. Say, all the camels that should have come are on their way. Now, so with that, we are now entering here in Alabama this new glory shift. I don't want to teach on this, but I want you to know why we gather is because there comes a moment for that shift to begin. And in that shift, when you start shifting, you start learning to go, you're going and you're doing. All of a sudden, you're empowered in a way. You're prophesying. Prophesying is not scary. It is you just saying the mind and heart of God into every situation that you run into. It has comfort about it. It has encouragement about it. It has exhortation about it. Sometimes you have to tear down and build up. It has direction in it, but it unlocks God's redemptive plan. What I showed you in that first slide is God's redemptive plan for Alabama. It is for the glory realm to be seen throughout an entire nation.